Hi everyone. Welcome to our English class. How are you? All you are fine? Then, by the last class, in the last week, we finished the new chapter, Arachne, and all the new words and terms are explained to you. I think that is very clear to you, and that chapter gave a wonderful message also to all the people. That means we may have different skills. Okay. Then when we have a new skill or when we have many skills, we can give its benefit to others. And we should have a mentality of helping others with our extra skill. And when others come to see or come to observe or come to make the benefit of our skill, we should not be proud of it like our character. Because all the skills are achieved because of our hard work and because of our talent, everything, that's okay. But we should be okay, we can be happy of that. But we should not be over proud like the Arachne in the story. So when we are becoming so proud, or when we are jealous, or when we are thinking others are nothing, I am the only one. When we think so, there is another person, he is watching and he gave such talents to us. So he can take it away like it happened in the case of Arachne. So, in the case of you also, you may have many, many, many talents and many, many skills. Somebody have wonderful drawing skill. Somebody may have wonderful singing skill. Many skills will be there for you. So, you make use of such skills to others also as a part of help. So, it will be improved daily, day by day. Or when you become proud, or when you are becoming jealous, or when you are seeing others are nothing, you will become nothing one day. Such days may come. Or when you are thinking others are great and I am nothing, I have no ability. Even if you have many, many ability, if you are thinking I have no ability, others are super, others are okay, if you are thinking so, if you are seeing others are great and I am poor, when you think so, the God will give great, great opportunity to you. And there will be many, many, many improvements in you. Or else, if you are thinking others are nothing and I am okay, if you are thinking so, there will be problems. That had happened in the case of whom? Our, you know, character Arachne. So don't think so. Be, think positively. Think others are great and I will help others as I can. So if you are thinking so and if you are doing so, there will be great, great achievement in your field. Such a message was given in that story. Okay. Now, today, we are going to finish the exercise part of that chapter. So for that, I would like you to, for that, I want you to take your textbook and open it at the page of the Arachne exercises. Okay, so everybody, take your textbook and also your writing materials, then watch the balance or the continuous part of the video. So we can go through the textbooks. Okay, take your books.
Now we are starting the exercise part with our textbook. So open the textbook at the exercise page of this chapter. So first two questions are, write true or false for the statements. Question number one, Arachne lived on the outskirts of a village surrounded by a meadows. Second question, Arachne was the eldest child of her parents. Then Arachne used to work hard along with her siblings. Then Arachne was a boastful and proud girl. Then the goddess Athene did not like Arachne's work. So these are the five statements related to our chapter. So you have to say whether it is true or false. Its answers are given here. So you look there and make it done in the textbook. Okay. I will show the answers in the next slide. Just look here. Here the answers are given. Look in the screen. Okay. By looking here, you can mark in the textbook. Five statements are there. So the answers are seen in the screen. Make or check your answers whether they are correct or not. So this is the first question for writing the answers true or false. Then we can move to the second question. Look here in the screen or look at the screen. Second question, answer the following questions. So for writing answers, four questions are there. First question, describe the beauty of Thessaly. You know, Thessaly was the village of whom? Arachne. So how beautiful it was, you have to describe. Then second question, how was Arachne different from her sibling? You know, Arachne, at the earliest stage, she was not like her other siblings. So what was the differences? Then what did Arachne excel at? Then was she humble about her skill? You know, what was her talents and how was her? So that you can explain. Then what advice did goddess Athene give to Arachne? You know, one advice was given to Arachne by the goddess Athene. What was that? So these are the four questions. Then its answers will be given in the next slide. Okay. So here the answers are there. Now you can pause the video and you can write by taking your own time. Look, Thessaly was a village at the foot of Mount Olympus. The village had meadows with streams running through it. The field had dragonflies whose wings flashed in the colors of a rainbow when the sun fell on it. The delicate foliage of trees and blue sky was a beautiful sight. Then daffodils grew in the green grass during early spring and blue irises fringed the river's bank. That was explained at the time of taking class. Now I'm not saying the meaning and other thing. So everything will be okay to you. Then write, and if you have doubt, you can ask. Then second answer, Arachne was a dreamy and quiet. She enjoyed watching the dragonflies in the sun. She was charmed with the delicate foliage of trees. Then she would sit for hours and gaze at the stately daffodils that grew in the green grass. Then third answer, Arachne was taught to work on the loom and weave, and she excelled in making the most beautiful pattern on the cloth. Her most talent, that was making beautiful pattern on the cloth. She was not humble but very proud of her skill. Then next, the goddess Athene advised Arachne to let visitors to came to see her tapestry, then discover for themselves how beautiful they are. No? Allow the visitors to select which was the beautiful one from the tapestry. That was the advice given by whom? The Athene. So next slide. higher order thinking skill. Just write that question first. Others you don't mind. This is only needed. And also in the next item, vocabulary, circle the correctly spelled word in each group. That also you can see there, it was ticked. The correctly spelled words was ticked. That also you look. Then the answer for the higher order thinking skill is given in the next slide. You can pause the video, then take your time and write. And in the case of that vocabulary, the correctly spelled words that was given here. So from here also you can see the correct answers. Okay. I am just moving. Take your time and write by pausing the video. Next, some exercise grammar part was given there that we will discuss in the offline class. Okay. So now a small part that is in the case of that writing area. In the next page you can see writing. The story is a sequence of events which led to the fall of a proud, boastful girl. Prepare a flowchart of events that took place in the life of Arachne. You know, many, many things happened in that story. So it was step-by-step process. Then, really, what happened there? A proud girl fell from that proud conditions. She became nothing when the Adin came there. So many steps are, many processes took place step by step. So what are the process that we want to write step by step? That we will say flow chart. So such a flow chart we have to make. Then that will be given in the next slide. You can copy and write without mistake. It is here. So like this, step by step you write. Arachne lived with her family in Thessaly. First, the next, Arachne was taught to work on the loom and weave. Then Arachne surpassed her sisters in weaving, means she overcome others. Next, Arachne became famous and people visited her home to see her tapestry. Many people came to see her work. Then Arachne became proud and boastful and challenged Adin, goddess of art. Now she became very proud and she challenged the goddess. Then Adin and Arachne worked on their loom. Then goddess Adin's tapestry was far superior to that of Arachne's work. Then Arachne felt ashamed about her boasting. So everything is given step by step. This also you can write by pausing the video. Take your time. Write neatly and clearly without any mistake. So by this chapter's exercise part we are concluding or finishing. Then we will start with another chapter in the next class. Mostly it will be from the term 2. Term 1, these chapters are only needed for the examination. So we will finish here. The next class onwards on English period, you take term 2 textbook. Okay, so we are stopping here. You take your video is concluding and you take your time and write, and if you have a doubt you can contact. I will clear your doubt. Okay, so with this we can finish and stop the class here. Write neatly and send it to me.